కాకతీయాలు ఎమర్జెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎ రీజనల్ కింగ్డమ్ ద కాకతీయాలు ఫ్రమ్ 1000 టు 1350 AD న్యూ రూలింగ్ ఫ్యామిలీస్ ఎమర్జ్డ్ ఆల్ ఓవర్ ఇండియా దీస్ అంబిషియన్స్ వారియర్స్ అండ్ కింగ్స్ ఫాట్ అగైన్స్ట్ ఈచ్ అదర్ కాన్స్టెంట్లీ అమిడ్ దిస్ సిచ్యువేషన్ అరోస్ ద కాకతీయ కింగ్డమ్ ఇన్ వరంగల్ This was also the time when the first book in Telugu was written. According to tradition, Kavitrayam composed Srimad Andhra Mahabharatam between 1000 and 1200 AD. We have a large number of inscriptions and a number of books written about the activities of the kings, queens, chief farmers, herders and traders in Sanskrit and Telugu. Vidyanath wrote Prataparudra Yashobhu Sahanam and also written after the end of their rule by Vinukonda Vallabharaya Kridhabiramamu Ekamranathas Prataparudra Charitamu. According to inscriptions and literature, the Kakatiyas adopted Telugu as the favored of the court. Most of their inscriptions are in Telugu and they also called them as Andhra Rajas. They also sought to bring together the three Telugu spoken regions. Thus, the Kakatiya kings tried to build a Telugu regional consciousness. The Kakatiyas. The early members of the dynasty hold the post of village heads called Rattadi and through their military skills and became army chiefs, Samanthas, etc. of Rashtrakuta and Chalukya kings who were ruling in Karnataka, later they gained control over Anmakonda in Telangana and emerged as independent rulers after the fall of Western Chalukyas. During Rudradeva's rule between 1158 to 1195 AD, the capital was shifted from Anmakonda to Orugallu. The new city was laid with a plan. Rudradeva built a big fort, a tank and a temple called Thousand Pillared Temple in Anmakonda. The outer fort wall consists of four gates. This protected agriculture lands and several water tanks within it. In this area were many huts of artisans. After crossing these, we come to the center where there was a fort wall made of mud. If we walk towards the center, we find another wall made of stone. The city buildings and palaces were within this stone wall and had four gates in four directions. From each gate, a main road went to the center of the city, where there was a temple Swayambhu Siva. This temple had also four gates into four directions. The city was divided into several quarters, vadas. People of a profession lived in their own distinct vadas. Kakatiya kings pursued many chiefs to accept them as their king. They protected their Samantha subordinates from other warriors and chiefs and also took the Samanthas with them when they went to conquer other kingdoms. Many of Samantha chiefs made attempts to become independent, but the Kakatiya kings sent armies to subdue them. Rudramadevi. Rudramadevi, a powerful and successful ruler, belonged to the famous Kakatiya family, ruled from Orugallu between 1262 AD to 1289 AD for nearly 27 years. She impressed one and all with her abilities. Rudramadevi dressed herself like a man and rode horses with ease. She called herself as Rudradev Maharaja. She faced opposition of man chiefs who had been under her father, but succeeded in subduing them. Rudramadevi and her grandson Prataparudra faced many revolts and took several steps to control these chiefs. Marco Polo, a famous Italian traveler, visited Rudramadevi's kingdom and stated that she was fearless. Nayankara system. Rudramadevi and Prataparudra encouraged several skilled warriors, though they were not from any powerful family, were given high positions and the titles of Nayaka. They were given several villages called Nayakara from where they could collect taxes. each Nayaka had to maintain army from the income they derived from the Nayankara for the service of the king. These Nayakas remained loyal to the king or the queen and were also used to subdue the rebellious chiefs. This arrangement was called Nayankara system. Encouragement to agriculture and temples. The Kakatiyas brought large tracts of land in the difficult terrains of Telangana and Rayalaseema under cultivation by building tanks and digging wells. Apart from members of royal family, the section of the society like merchants, artisans and other feudal families also participated in expanding agriculture. Kakatiyas extensively patronized temples by making large donations to them. By promoting agriculture, they derived income in the form of taxes and agriculture produce. Women members of the royal families and women of other rich sections also made gifts of land, tanks, cash, cattle, jewelry to temple and Brahmins. Trade. Warriors, chiefs and kings derived much of their income by taxing traders, especially from the ports. The end of Kakatiyas. The new kings called sultans came from Turkestan, had a powerful army and were able to defeat most of the kings of North India and the Deccan. Sultan Muhammad bin Tughlaq defeated Kakatiya king Pratap Rudra in 1323 AD. Thus ended the Kakatiya dynasty.
మా వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్.